Do you need to switch from the APA 6 to the APA 7th referencing style? This video describes 5 of the most important changes that you should be aware of. Firstly, there have been changes to the way in-text citations are formatted. In the APA 6th style, there were special rules for sources that had 3 to 5 authors, where you had to list all the authors the first time you use the source and then use the et al. For subsequent citations. Now, however, you can start using the et al. Setting from the first time you use it for any source that has 3 or more authors. So in the past, you used to have to reference like this. However, now in APA 7th style, you can just list the first author's surname followed by et al. And the year. Secondly, there have been changes to the way books are referenced. In the past, you needed to list the place of publication for the book. This caused some problems, particularly when publishing houses had multiple places of publication. In the new APA 7th referencing style, you no longer need to include the location of the publisher. Here is an example of a correctly referenced APA 7th book, and the arrow indicates to you where there used to be a place for publication, but now it is only listing the publishing house. Thirdly, there have been changes to the way you represent references in the reference list when there are multiple authors. In the past, you needed to list the first 6 authors followed by an ellipse and the last author. However, this has changed and now you are writing the numbers up to 20 authors. So when there are 20 authors in the reference, you should include all their names. When it goes above 20 authors, you should list the first 19 names, then an ellipsis, and then the final name. This is an example of what that would look like, with the circle indicating the ellipsis that you need. There have also been changes in the way that the DOI is represented in the reference. In the past, you needed to list the label DOI with a colon, and you needed to list only the letters and numbers that were listed. However, now it has changed and DOIs are listed as hyperlinks. You also no longer need that DOI label. So this is an example of a journal article, and you will note there with the arrow how the DOI is now represented for a journal article. Similarly, there have been changes to the way a URL is represented. In the past, you needed to list retrieved from and the URL. But now you can actually list them as hyperlinks and you no longer need that retrieved from writing. So this is an example of what that would look like in the new APA 7th referencing style. So in summary, the changes that have been made have been made to improve the clarity of the reference and to incorporate hyperlinks, particularly for the DOI and the URL.